Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. Whenever we have an urge of doing something because we have got lot of time at our disposal and we don't want to waste time. If this thing comes, this is the sprout of ego. Thank God for cooling it down. So, when we have this I, there is the echo in this mic. Ask him to reduce. Come karo jara. Make it less. There is echo. No treble and no brass. And reduce it little bit. Better. Can you all hear me? Even if you don't, doesn't matter. Because before the lecture you are, during the lecture you are, after the lecture you are, that is important. Lecture is not important. So, this ahankar is only this. There are three stages through which ahankar is born. First, janati, we know something. Then, ichchati, then we desire that thing. And then karoti, we act according to the desire. If we do not know, we do not desire. If we do not desire, we do not act. No karma. Therefore, wherever there is an urge to do this or do that, it's a very clear sign of the ahankar. Therefore, ahankritim jo lasati grasitva, kim tasya karyam parishishtam asti. He who has thus dissolved this ego, ahankar, can there be any obligation for him left in this world? Kim karya asti. See? Bhagavan said the same thing in Gita. Yesterday I told you. Yastvatma ratireva syat atma truptascha manavaha atmanneva cha santushtaha tasya karyam na vidyate. He who is abiding in self, for him there is no karyam vidyate, there is no obligation left for him. Be attentive. That doesn't mean that he should not work in this world. See, it is something like, you know, a servant goes to an organization to work, some charitable organization, which is running basically on the volunteers. Although there are major portion volunteers, yet there are few of them who are paid servants. So when the paid servant doesn't go on time or if he is late, he is subjected to punishment and rules and regulations. But if the volunteer, he is supposed to go, if he has not gone, does it mean that he is punishable? No. See, the volunteer is doing the job without becoming a doer. Apply this principle. If we have zero ego, there is no obligation left for us in this world. And if we feel there is some obligation left, we are far away from the truth. Therefore, let the things happen. Don't struggle to do this, do that. Kinchit vijanati sa natmanonyat tasya sthitim bhavitum kshamakaha. So, such a wise man, what is his experience? We can't even imagine. Because we have the constant urge to do this, do that, do this, do that. See, friends, one principle I'll tell you, try to work on it. Any person who has to do something in this world, he will always utilize us. He who has nothing to do in this world, he alone will guide us properly. See, like, you know, this Ravi, I went to his house for breakfast. Now, I had some problem with my some work. And the moment I came to know he is expert in that field, immediately I bounce upon him. See, you do it for me. See how simple it is. Therefore, here the teacher very clearly tells, Sa na vijanati atmanaha anyat. He who doesn't know anything else other than being the self, tasya sthitim, what is his experience? What is the experience of remaining by doing nothing? Friends, spiritual practice is not doing anything. Spiritual practice is undoing everything. Spiritual practice is not becoming spiritual, but it is unbecoming everything. Therefore, give it a try to yourself. Decide. Next 5 minutes, I am going to waste time. Nothing is to be done. There is nothing important. See? Give it a try. And then you will understand what Bhagavan Krishna said. Sukha dukkhe same krutva labha labho jaya jayo tato yuddhaya yujjaswa naivam papam avapsasi. Means what? Means when the victory, defeat, gain, loss, joy, sorrows come, we remain equanimous to that. But that means what? Victory, defeat is same for us. Gain, loss is same. Joy, sorrows are same. Then why you are doing all these things? I am not doing. Time pass. Whenever you do anything for a time pass, ego is not born. When we are playing with the child, cricket, you know, in this children's camp, I used to play cricket. I say, on one condition, I will do only batting. Don't ask me to run here and there. Okay. And once that child threw the ball and immediately shouted, LBW, LBW. I said, there cannot be LBW, there is no leg. How can there be LBW? He said, no, Swamiji, for you, LBW means lungi before rugate. Not leg. The ball has got entangled in your lungi. For him, I was out. For me, it was a fun. Whether I am out or I hit a sixer, it is the same. See, friends, tasya karyam na vidyate. Therefore, where there is no doership, there is no ego. Now, aham sputam tattvam isiti vedam, tathapya samprapya paratmanishtham, bhuyo vicharo mati durbalatvam tat sarvada svatmataya hi bhati. It is very clearly mentioned in the Veda. See, about Veda, please understand basic things of spiritual life. When we give importance only to the inert matter, like physics, chemistry, maths, etc., basic sciences, we are working only on dead matter, far away from the truth. First step. All the scientists fall in this category. Then the second step. When we are living in this world, we focus attention on our quality of interaction with the world. How I interact? Should not tell lies, should not hurt others, should respect everybody, love everybody, love all, serve all, and while serving, shout at all. So, from here, the absolute basic science, we graduate, we come at a stage called a Dharma Shastra. Dharma Shastra takes this relative world as real. From there we again graduate. And then we come to Upasana Shastra. In Dharma Shastra we have, what we have done, that if I do good, I get everything good in return. If I do bad, I get bad thing in return. So we are living under fear psychosis. From there we graduate, we come to Upasana. In Upasana, our attention is now on the divine principle. Little bit still more. So, first was Adibhautik lifestyle, wherein world and relations with the world are important, that is called as the Adibhautik lifestyle. Second is Adidaivik lifestyle, wherein we invoke the powers of the nature. Krishna, 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 Om Trambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Urvarukam Yavandhanan Mrityor Mukshiyamamrutan Om Bhurvusvata Savitarvarenyam. We invoke the divine powers, Adidaivik aspect of spiritual life. Then we come to Adhyatmik. Kshetradnyam chapi mam viddhi sarva kshetreshu bharata. Arjun, recognize, there is but one reality which is expressing in and through the totality. This is Adhyatmik Shastra. See, these are the three stages through which we go. So when we are at the Adi Bhautik Shastra, Dharma Shastra, we should do good to others, we should not tell lies, blah, blah, blah. Early to bed and early to rise. Such people are in KG1. Now the second stage is Upasana. In that Upasana, we are all the time crying, oh Lord, kindly do this, kindly do that. Meaning what? You become my servant and do my job. I am going for a picnic, take care of my house. Okay. Therefore, all our gods have got a smile on their face. Aageya. All the gods know very clearly, this fellow has come to give me a job. Kindly do this, do that, do that. Therefore, when people give me pressure, Swamiji, isko baato, I get so annoyed. You baato, mujhe kyun bata rahe? See? Therefore, Adidaivik, then we come to Adhyatmik. So, Mantra Bhag is Adibhautik. Upasana Kanda in the Vedas is Adidaivik. And Upanishadik Jnanam is Adhyatmik spiritual science. See, friends. So, here the teacher says, Aham sputam tattvamasiti vedaha. So what the Vedas ultimately tell, the ultimate instruction of the Vedas, tattvamasi, you are that. Tadeva brahmatvam vidhi, nedam yadidam upasate, that Brahman thou art. Therefore, bhuyo vichara, once you have come to discover this truth, be attentive. In front of you on the backdrop, there is a cloth, black cloth. Now it is a black cloth. Now do you or we have to do japa? It's a black cloth, it's a black cloth, it's a black cloth. It's not a white baba, it's a black. No. Be attentive. That knowledge which requires repetition falls in the purview of relativity. That knowledge which falls in the repeatability falls in the purview of the knowledge gained through sense organs, mind and intellect. But that knowledge which is not through the sense organs or mind or intellect, that knowledge does not require repetition. Take an example. We have learned riding a bicycle. We learn riding a bicycle only once in our life. We don't learn every day, once we learn. And once we learn, we never forget. The reason is, we have not learned riding a bicycle by our intellect, by our mind, by our sense organs, by our organs of action. See? Therefore, mati durbalatvam. Don't have that wrong notion. No, 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 I will forget. Let me do ram, 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 ram. Fearful existence is not spiritual life. See, friends. Therefore, bhujo vicharaha mati durbalatvam tat sarvada swatmataya hi bhati. We can never have any doubt once we know the truth. And you know the simplest part. There are two types of knowledges. One type of knowledge demands action as a follow-up. See? If you go from here to the right and go straight away, you will end up in a Maharaja Bhog Hotel. Yes, you heard it. Yes. What next? Are pocha tune? You go. You go also. So action followed by, rather knowledge followed by action. One type of knowledge. Second type of knowledge, this is a mogra flower. What action? So there are two types of knowledges. One type of knowledge demands follow-up through action. Second type of knowledge doesn't demand. We are told if you do Gayatri Japa 24 lakhs times, 2400 times, you will have Brahma Teja. Okay, but I am not having. But have you done 2400,000 times? Oh, I have to do that japa, of course. I thought only by hearing it will happen. Do it and done. Tattvamasi doesn't tell us, do this. See? Yan manasana manute yena ahur manomatam tadeva brahmatvam viddhi. First step. That which cannot be comprehended by the mind. Second thing. That which gives the capacity in the mind to comprehend the things, that is the Brahman. Third, fourth, that Brahman thou art. Fifth, Viddhi, you have to only know. And this knowledge doesn't require a follow-up through upasana or action. Tadeva Brahmatvam Viddhi. Nedam yadinu upasate. There is no upasana required. Oh, I am Brahman. No. That is why many seekers, when they are doing upasana, and if they come to this point to discard upasana, they get shaken up totally. There was one Swami, name was Madhavananda, I don't know where is he now. He came for studies. And he was basically a devotee of Bhagavan Sri Krishna. So having his puja, poti, and you know, every day he has to do puja or shaligram. And they will be decorating shaligram, giving a nice eyes and nose and everything. And put the clothes. Like, you know, our Swami Narayan people are the Pushti Margi they do. They decorate the god so beautifully. Now, if they are told, Nedam yadidam upasate, discard all this upasana. They feel so bad. So this Swami who came to study, whole life he was doing ghanti vajav. And when he came for study, he became so disgusted. See, we only say, tyage neke amrutatva manashu. We have to give up all our notions if they are proved to be wrong. And if we are not ready to give up our wrong notions, then we are not walking the spiritual path. We are not on the adhyatmic marga. We are only in the upasana. Upasana is only a means. It is not the goal. Adhyatma is attained through this recognition of the self. Na vedmiham mamuta vedmiham mam iti pravado manujasya hasyaha drugdrush. Drugdrushya bhedat kime ki mayam dvidhatma svatmaikatayam na dhyam na bhedaha. See, I have not realized. Shailen Swamiji, can you please help me that I can realize? Teacher says, na vedmi aham, I have not known the truth. Oh, therefore, vedmi aham mam, I want to know myself. Iti pravadaha manujasya hasyaha. These kind of discussions are worthy of ridicule. It is something like that. I don't have tongue in my mouth. Can this statement be said? If you don't have tongue in the mouth, why are you talking? And if you don't have tongue in the mouth, you will not talk. See? So grammatically it is okay. It's not possible. Exactly the same way that I don't know myself, I have to know the truth, I have to realize. And then again problem comes, Swamiji, what? After realization, what will I do? Later you are not realized, keep busy. What are you doing? I am realizing these days. Have you realized? Navy chal raha hai. See, friends. Once you get into this, everything just disappears like a mist on the green leaves. Just disappears. Nothing remains which can bother you. Iti pravado manujasya asyaha. Druk drishya bhedat kim ayam dvidhatma. Is this the knower and the knowledge and knower and the known are different? See? Paramatma with the conditioning of names and forms is called as the world. Paramatma with the conditioning of the panchakoshas is called as the person. Man with the conditioning of the father is called as son. Man with the conditioning of his son is called as father. So this man, are they two, father and the son? Man is one. With the conditionings, he is referred in two different ways. Now when both the conditionings go away, the father dies and the son dies, thereafter, the father and the son have, the son and the father have gone, but the man is as he is. See, friends, how simple it is. Therefore, druk drishya bhedat kim ayam dvidhatma. Is this self knower and the known difference? No. See, this experience can give you some glimpses. When our own finger goes in our eye for whatever reason, that time do we chop off the finger? Finger is different, eyes are different. So although they are different from each other, yet there is no differentiation on account of the differences. See? So perception of differences is not the problem. When the perception of differences is followed by differentiation on some criteria, then alone the samsara begins. See, the mother looks at the daughter and the daughter-in-law. Both are seen as separate from the mother. But when it comes to the daughter-in-law, then there is differentiation on account of the differences. When it comes to her own daughter, then there is no differentiation. After all, she is my daughter. How she can be bad? On the contrary, it is the other way around. If she is your daughter, how can be she good? See, friends. Therefore, svatmaikatayam na dhyam na bhedaha. Be attentive. Our being is not recognized through any means of knowledge. See, I am man, I am woman, I am young, I am old, I am educated, I am uneducated, I am rich, I am poor. This requires some kind of conditioning, means of knowledge. But I am, our presence does not require any means of knowledge. Swatmaiketayam na dhyam. This is not the knowledge gained through the medium of thoughts. Knowledge gained through the medium of thoughts is mental projection. Whether you see a demon in your dream or you see God in your dream, both are mental projections. But seeing the God is better than seeing the dream, as seeing the demon. But ultimately both of them are the same. Therefore, svatmaikatayam na dhyam na bhedaha. And therefore, there is no difference between knower and the known. Where the difference between knower and the known disappears, that is called as ananda. That experience where knower known, experiencer experienced, the duality dissolves into homogeneous one. That experience is called as ananda. See? The waking world known, waker knower. In deep sleep, neither there is a waking world nor there is a knower. What happened? Both of them dissolved into one homogeneous experience. And therefore, in deep sleep, it is bliss. Ice cream is in the pot and the tongue is in the mouth. Till they are separate, there is misery. Jaldi dono. No, first of all we chant 15th chapter of Gita. Ice cream, what is, there is no mention anywhere in Bhagavad Gita before eating ice cream is chant 15th chapter of Gita. Give me quickly. So when the known and the knower, experienced and experiencer, when they are separate, it is an experience of misery. And when that ice cream known or experienced and the tongue experiencer, when they come together, their division, their differences, their separateness disappears immediately. Mouth, eyes, everything closes. Ananda is this. Our struggle is to get ananda by indulging with the world. You cannot. What we get is only pleasure. Pleasure is not ananda. See? So, svatmaikatayam na dhiyam na bhedaha rutprapya saddhama nijaswarupe saddhama siddhe anupalabhya nishtham maya vilasa sadasat swarupa virupananaika mukha pravadaha. See? Rutprapya saddhama nijaswarupe anurabhya nishtham. Unless we are firmly abiding in our absolute conscious blissful existence, svabhava siddhe, it is our natural state. We have got two stages. One is called as the essential self, the natural self, essential self. Second is the acquired self. Essential self is Satchidananda. You cannot change it. Even if you don't want, you are divine. Look. You are divine. So that is our essential self. What is the acquired self? Acquired self is I am Kannadiga, I am a Gujarati, acquired self. I am a man with education, you are a woman without education, acquired self. I am loving, I love plants, I love animals. Naturally, those who don't love human beings, they have to find out some way. All the dog lovers fall in this category. Those who cannot love God, they love dogs. Spelling ulta hai. And why they love dogs? Because it is a one-way traffic. You want the other person to love you according to your convenience. If that is what you want, have a dog. If you want a husband who will eat whatever is given. If you want a husband, whatever you scold him, he keeps quiet. Then get married to a dog. Give him something. See, friends, There was one girl in Gujarat, Ahmedabad, very beautiful looking, extremely intelligent. She did her MBA, etc. By the time she was hardly 21, 22. Started her own industry. Within a period of 3-4 years, her turnover was in crores. So successful. By then she was about 27, 28. Now her father tells me, Swamiji, please tell her to get married. Any boy we show she doesn't like. I said, look here, Papa, you don't understand. She wants someone who is more handsome than her. She wants someone who is more capable than her. She wants someone who is more educated than her. She wants someone who is more successful than her. Is it not, beta? Yes, Swami, you have understood, but Papa doesn't understand. I said, I have not completed. And you want someone who will listen to you. The one who has the first four qualities, he will not have the fifth quality. See, friends, this is how the samsara is born. Therefore, unless we abide in our essential self, you go on talking about that this world is maya, etc. Who cares what it is? See? Swabhava siddhe. So we have got one essential nature. He is Satchidananda. Acquired nature, all other paraphernalia that we have created. Therefore, then what happens? We keep on discussing about the world. Now what is this world? Maya vilasaha. This world is the creation of Maya. Nobody has seen either the Maya or the world. Then Sarasvarupa. It is with the form, without the form. Virupa, no, it is without the form. And Nana, it is multiplicity is the world. No, Eka, the non-multiplicity is the world. Keep on discussing, you will end nowhere. See, friends, give it a treat to yourself. Expose yourself to utter silence. Means, do not talk to yourself. Exposing to utter silence doesn't mean you close yourself in a room and then no sound should come. Stomach sound will start coming. Gudu 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 gudu. Bhook lagi. See, friends, that is not the one. Do not talk to yourself. Let there be a chaos all around, wherever you are. No reactions, no comments, no discussions, no evaluations, no labeling. Then the world will not have any power to influence us. See? Therefore, the simplest technique I told you a number of times, as you listen to my talks, listen to the world. See how simple it is. These talks do not make any difference. Kitne mahatma aake chale gaye, try on me, huh? So we sit as a challenge to the Mahatma, try to improve upon me, try. I have deserted many, you are second. So technique we have. So what is our technique? As if we are listening. The same way, when we are told that you are Sachidananda Brahman, you are full of the highest order. Why did you say like that? Because the first thing we did not hear, the second thing we heard. Impact. So, these are pravadaha, unwanted discussion. Naradji says in Narad Bhakti Sutra, vado na avalambyaha. Do not take refuge in discussions, arguments. One of the most essential spiritual practice. No discussions, no argument. There was one Gujarati couple in Australia. So my host told me, Swamiji, here there is one Gujarati couple. They are very good, you know, both of them are nice people. But both of them keep on constantly fighting. I feel pity for them. Will you please talk to them? I said, this is an inquiry or order? No, Swamiji, I want you to talk to them. I said, so this is order. Okay, then call him. So we had tea, coffee. And now I said, no, not here. We'll go for a walk so that my walking is also done and you can talk. And we were walking in a garden and there was a flower bed and there were some big flowers, beautiful flowers. So I just stood, I said, hey, see what a beautiful dahlia flower. So husband said, yes, Swamiji, it's very good. Wife says, it is not dahlia. No, no, it is dahlia. And both of them started arguing and fighting on what is the name of that fool. When these fellows were fighting about what is the name of that flower, that fool was laughing at them. Two fools have come to look at me. See? So when I saw that, then I had diagnosed immediately. I said, you people discuss, argue on non-essentials. Then you require some common factor, which is your common enemy. I said, next time I come, I want a baby. Don't argue now. I want to have a baby, you must give me. Next year I went, after 2 years rather, they had a baby. Then I asked my friend, I said, hey, how is that Gujju couple? Swamiji, they have no problem. So I went, I said, hey, what is the secret? Swamiji, we have a common enemy. See, when you have a common enemy, you get united. That's why when WhatsApp came to me, the terrorists unite us, the politicians divide us. So let us invite the terrorists in our country, we'll remain united. Therefore, no discussion, no argument. Siddhasya vitti sata eva siddhi sapnopamana kalu siddhayo anya. Real siddhi is recognition of your divine self. That is the real siddhi. All other siddhis, touch method siddhi, sapnopamana. They are like the dreams. See, friends, this is very difficult to transcend. Because as the mind starts becoming purer, subtler, and near dissolving in the divine, all the hidden potentiality in the mind starts surfacing. And those hidden potentialities, which were earlier covered because of too much of involvement in the world, they were dormant. They start surfacing. And that is what is called a siddhi. Friends, like the in the outer world, the achievements, etc., or failure, friends or enemies, they are the bondages which do not allow us to come out of this world. In the same manner, in the subtle world, the siddhis are the obstacles for a spiritual seeker. See? But majority of the people, what they want siddhis. So you'll see where there is a huge crowd where that Babaji tells, come here, gives one on his face and he's wise suddenly. See, this is what we want. This is how the majority of the people are. Therefore, Swapno Samana Kalusiddhaya Anya Swapna Prabuddhasya Kathamnu Satya. The one who is awakened from the dream, for him, all the achievements and failures in the dream, will it have any meaning at all? In the same manner, he who is awakened from this relative existence and abiding in the absolute, for him, when there is no one other than I, be attentive, when there is no one other than I, will I try to prove anything to anybody? Will I try to justify anything? See? We want to prove something to somebody because somebody is other than me. And therefore, every time you are given writing, I love you, Lelo. Like the kids. Yesterday I went to somebody's house, a small child prepared a very beautiful, greeting card. Dear Swami Ji, Swami Anubhavananda, from, I don't know what the name, something like that. All nice colors and all the sticking. Yes. Every time we have to prove that I love you. But you have not given me anything, only she has given. You don't love me. Enough for the child to cry, oh, I didn't love Swamiji. No. Don't try to prove anything to anybody in this world. Our whole life is a struggle. We try to prove. Swamiji, I love you. Who cares? Don't try. Similarly, don't justify anything in life. Whenever we justify, we are doubtful about ourselves. Don't justify. Nobody will ask us. This is how the ego takes different shapes and forms. So, we are not interested in proving anything to anybody, no siddhis, no nothing. Like, some people ask us, Swamiji, do you see the palm? I said, no, I show the palm. Ek laga do, sab thikane par hai. Soham vicharo vapuratma bhave sahayakari paramarganasya swatmaika siddhau sa punar nirartho yatha naratva pramiti narasya. Soham vicharaha vapuratma bhave sahayakari paramarganasya. As long as you are living as the body, till then this soham sadhana is useful only till such time you take yourself to be body. And once you have accepted, at least theoretically, that you are the embodied and not the body. See, friends. Then what is the soham sadhana? See, hakarena bahiryati sakarena vishet punaha. This simple thing I will tell you. Take Hari Om. And you all must be doing japa. So in that japa, we are told to chant Lord's name. 108 beads are there. So we keep on chanting Hari Om, Hari Om, Hari Om, Hari Om, Hari Om, Hari Om. The idea is every breath is kriya shakti. And every chanting Hari Om is jnana shakti. These two must merge together. Merging of the jnana and kriya is consciousness. Therefore, this is the technique given. When breathe in, say to yourself in your mind, Hari. When breathe out, Om. Thus, the mind, jnana shakti, breathing, the kriya shakti, they become perfectly synchronized. You must have seen sometime, on TV or something. The lip sync is not proper. That person is talking something, but the lips are not synchronizing properly. Exactly the same way, our life is non-synchronized presentation of a video. The mind is going with the speed of a race horse. And the body is going with the speed of a buffalo. What will be the condition of that bullock cart? Exactly the same way. Therefore, when these two things are synchronized, both of them are attaining perfect balance and ultimate merger in pure consciousness. Till then, continue. It is but only the means, it is not the goal. So, sahayakari paramarganasya swatmaika siddhau na punar nirarthaha. And once you are abiding in the self, then everything drops automatically. Those who are sincerely observing their own spiritual practice, they will come to know Initially, how much one gets involved into a typical type of asana is required, then mala, which mala we should take, whether Rudraksha or the Tulasi mala, it should be in the gold or it should be in the silver or it should be in the silk, it should be in cotton, what should be made up of. If it is hybrid mala, in Nepal we went, and in the shopping one lady got this mala. It was having one Rudraksha, one Spatika, one more thing, and one Tulasi, four of them. Swamiji, what is this called as? Is it powerful? It is very powerful. Why? It is hybrid. There is a hybrid vigor in this mala. Because one is Rudraksha, second is Rudraksha will give you dispassion, second is the Spatika will give you wealth. So, you'll get confused. That becomes the major thing initially. Afterwards, slowly, slowly, everything drops up to the extent, even chanting stops. Like when the fruit matures, it separates from the mother tree effortlessly. And when that fruit separates from the mother tree effortlessly, the fruit is not feeling bad. Or, I have to separate from me. No. See, everything drops away. Therefore, svatmaika siddhau sapuna nirataha yatha naratva pramiti narasya. When we awake from the sleep and then we know that I am a man, thereafter we don't do the same practice. I'm a man, I'm not a woman, I'm a man. See, I got a beard, I'm a man. Nobody doubted you. But when you go on telling again and again, I'm a man, then people start doubting you. Why? See, friends, there's no need. So, dvaitam vichare paramartha bodhe tu advaitam itesha dasadhu adaha. This is not the right thinking. The sadhuvadaha. What is that? When you are thinking about this world, it is the duality. But when you are attaining absolute reality, then it is advaita. No, this is not the meaning. See, in Vedanta Shastra, initially this thought comes. One thing is called as the vyavaharik satya. Vyavaharik satya means what? When you are living in the family, mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife, you have to do the vyavahar, you have to conduct according to these relations. You cannot say, everybody is a mother for me, including my wife. No. See? So, vyavaharik satya is dvaita. And absolute reality is advaita. This is not the right thinking. This is KG1, KG2. Because, example given, gaveshanat prag dashame vinashte paschacha labde dashamatvamekam. This is the most powerful and beautiful story in the Vedanta Granthas. It is said, there were 10 fools, murkha, mahamurkha, murkha shiromani, mahamurkha shiromani, etc. 10 of them. And they were crossing a river. There was no boat, etc. So they decided, let's swim out. So they crossed the river. After going to the other bank, then they thought, let us count everybody has come or not. So they stood in a line. One of them came out and counted. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. See, I told you, we are only 9. 10th is lost. The other say, you don't know counting properly. Come here, I'll go and count. He comes out and they come, 1, 2, 3, 9. Everybody tries, it is 9. So majority, democracy. So majority say that it is only 9. Then what is to be done? Then cry. So they sit together and cry. The 10th person has gone. Then average man is going by that. A man with common sense. He says, hey, why are you crying? Why are you crying? See, we were 10, only one is left because we crossed the river. Within that time, this average common sense person counts, they are already 10. He said, look here, First of all, your 10th man is not lost. Step 1. Then sit together in a circle, they sat together. Now I'll take this danda and start hitting on your head. When I hit, you say 1, 2, and then you count, I'll not count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. When the 10th comes, he gives hard. 10. 10. Very good. Then again he starts on the second person. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10. 10. Is there? Huh? 10 is there. Like every person is a 10th person. And he was never lost. So should we say, when they did not know, that time they were 9, and after they know, they became 10? In the same manner, there is nothing like, when there is vyavahara, there is dvaita, when there is paramartha, there is advaita. This is the wrong understanding. See, friends, but we give so much importance to this worldly conduct, that becomes the primary thing. See, don't do this, don't do that. See, there is one book I read. I really like that book. It is an account given by an old devotee of Bhagwan Ramana Maharshi. Oh, we are reading the same book. Bhagwan Ramana Maharshi, he was earlier, you know, associated with Arvindo Ghosh of Pondicherry. So he used to stay in that ashram, very dedicated person, very sincere, and there so many rules and regulations. Don't do this, don't do that. This particular time, Mahatma come, do namaskar, get out, don't touch the feet. Oh, 101 rules. You cannot go out anywhere. You have to take permission. You can't eat onion. You can't eat this thing. During daytime, at night you can eat. All kinds of rules and regulations. And then he happened to come in contact with with Ramana Maharshi, what with Ramana Maharshi? Don't forget the earlier sentence. He came in contact with Ramana Maharshi. Like, you know, your MP3, When you stop it, again you start, it start from there. So he came in contact with Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi, and in his mere presence, no word, no discussion, no rules, no regulations. Come whenever you want, said, and go, you go. No, nothing. And he tells, he wrote this at the age of 90 plus. Somebody wrote, he never wanted to write anything, but he ultimately told. And then he was, what is his experience was totally different and worthy than what he was living there in Pondicherry. So he asked, sir, I want to go and stay with Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi. No, you cannot go. It will be Guru Droha. First year gone. Second time again he tried. No, you cannot go. If you go, it will be a curse. Again, third time, third year he asked. I really want to go. Please allow me to go. Anyway, you have decided to go. What can I do? Go. But then you'll regret afterwards. You won't get there anything. Friends, this is not spiritual life. See, you don't have to get anything. Till such time, we have this notion that realization means I will get something. We are in the wrong understanding. Take a simple example. Sleep is attained when we give up all our possessions, all our relations, and also the desire to sleep. Such a simple thing called as the sleep demands complete giving up everything. Abiding in the absolute. Will it entertain any relative achievements as great? See, friends. Therefore, Gaveshanat Prak Dashame Vinashte. It is not that before realization it was duality, after realization it is non-duality. No. It is the same reality which has never changed. Because of duality, it has never become dual. Because of absence of duality, it has not gained non-duality. It is its natural state. Karomi karmeti naro vijanan badhyo bhavet karma phalam cha bhoktum vicharadhuta hrudikartruta chet karmatrayam nashyati saiva muktihi. Karomi karmeti naro vijanan badhya bhavet karma phalam cha bhoktum. Till such time we have this notion, I am doing this, you will have the karma phala and you will have to go through good and bad. Be attentive. When you take yourself to be miserable, rather you take yourself to be husband, you will be miserable. When you take yourself to be the body, you will be born, you will grow, you will have diseases, you will die. When you take yourself to be the soul, you will be again and again born, go from one body to another body. And if you recognize you are the one reality on which the multiplicity is only appearing because of the multiplicity of the conditioning, in that abidance, if you remain, all the earlier three disappear. See, friends, two children were playing home. And husband, brother ask the wife, sister, give me something to eat. So the wife, you know, the children, when they play a game, this home, there is no script writer. Because everything is happening in the house. They know everything by heart. When the husband asks, give me something to eat, the wife says, the moment you enter the house, eat. Don't you have anything to do or what? Eat my head. Then the husband says, that is why I am hungry. It is empty. And then out of anger she comes and takes, as if she opens the fridge and takes, take, this is yesterday's leftover sabji and 2 days before we made puri, eat that. Now that boy, husband says to his sister, wife, hey, wait for a moment. What happened, bhaiya? See, you are not giving me actually, is it not? Only just you are showing as if you are giving something. Yes. But then why don't you think, okay, take rasagulla and jalebi. See, you are, when you are giving old sabji, it is only imagination. So why don't you imagine something good? Apply this principle. I am body, is it not imagination? I am soul, is it not imagination? I am husband, is it not imagination? It is the highest imagination. See? Because when you are in deep sleep, where is you the husband? Where is you the wife? Where is you the man? Where is you the woman? Where do they go? Because they are not, it is only in imagination. So the question is, if you have to imagine, why don't you imagine, I am Brahman? No, how can I be Brahman? We are goofy. Narayan. So, karomi karmeti naro vijanan, badyo bhavet karma phalam cha bhuktum. Then you are bound to get the karma phala and suffer. What is to be done? Give up kartutva abhiman. I am doing. No. There is nothing like kriya phala. There is only karma phala. Like when we are taken food on Ekadashi, it is, you have done a bad karma. What will happen? Go to hell straight away. Non-stop flight is there. But after the food has gone inside, if you have got constipation or diarrhea, there is no sin or merit. Because we do not digest the food. Food gets digested. Therefore, vichara dhuta hrudi kartruta chet. And if one has properly inquired and find out, and if still the kartrutva abhiman remains, that no, I have done this, I will do this thing, then he is still in the bondage. And if proper inquiry, you come to discover there is nothing like doer, therefore there is nothing like karma, therefore there is nothing like karma bandhan, therefore there is nothing like freedom or liberation. See, everything disappears. The freedom from this kartrutva abhiman, the sense of doership, is the real freedom. Baddhatva bhave sati moksha chinta bandhastu kasyeti vicharanena siddhe svayam svatmani nitya mukte kva bandha chinta kvacha moksha chinta. We only imagine we are miserable. We are not man. We are not miserable. One day one lady came, I was enjoying my cup of tea. When I prepare my cup of tea, I enjoy. When others prepare my cup of tea, they enjoy. I suffer. So I was enjoying my cup of tea. That time this lady dropped from somewhere. Straight away, Swamiji, I am very miserable, please help me. Spoiled my tea meditation. So I became angry. I said, Mama, shut up, sit quiet. She never expected I can shout also like that, shut up. Repeat after me whatever I say. And then I told, say, I am happy. Say, I am happy. But Swamiji, say, did I say but Swamiji? Only say what I am telling. I am happy. Okay, I am happy. I said, okay, continue 108 times. I am happy. When her note changed, tone changed, then I said, Mama, stop now. No, tell me sincerely, are you miserable? No, that way. All those who are miserable, they are trying to seek attention. See, that is ego. See, friends. More the ego, more seeking attention. See? And if that person doesn't get attention, gets hurt because ego is there. So this is a very simple equation. More miserable we become, more ego. Less miserable we become, less ego. Bhagwan has no ego, therefore Paramananda. So what will be spiritual practice? Be happy. You come back only to that. There is nothing else. See, friends. Therefore, baddhatva bhave sati moksha chinta. We go imagining, I am miserable. Then you try to become happy. So what we do? We go to Gangaji, become Gangadas. There also we don't get happiness. We go to Jamunaji, become Jamunadas. There also we don't get happiness. Finally, we come home and liquid spirituality, Devadas. Hey, friends. Don't seek happiness. Search for happiness is the most miserable event in our life. Don't seek happiness. Then express happiness. How to express? Start insisting you are happy. Insist. Again and again. If anybody asks you, how are you? Don't tell the truth. Because somebody has done a mistake doesn't mean you take a revenge. Achha, bataungi, bataungi. Therefore, I never ask anybody about their life. Because the moment you ask, immediately that, you know, like a dam burster, the dam burst out. Therefore, baddhatva bhave sati moksha chinta. If you think you are miserable, then you think to become happy. See, a person who is hungry, he wants food. Person who is thirsty, he wants water. Person who is miserable, he wants happiness. And if you are already happy, why worry for the moksha? So, baddhatva bhave sati moksha chinta, bandhastu kasye iti vicharane na. And then you find out, who is in bondage? I, the husband, is in bondage. Now find out, who is husband? Vicharane na. Husband is the eternal divine principle called as man, expressing through the limitations of a terrible thing called as a woman, becoming wife, and the moment the wife is born, husband is born. The husband and wife, they are relative. In relative world, you cannot get absolute happiness. You get only relative happiness. See how simple it is. Now what is to be done? You don't have to divorce. You don't have to kill her. Then don't take her seriously. Eh? Then what will happen? Although you are a husband, you will be happy. See? And for that one technique I told the other day, I developed one gadget. You can download that. It is a software gadget. It's an app. It's called as selective hearing app. When your wife talks to you or husband talks to you, whatever is convenient and useful that you listen. Rest of the things you don't listen. You will never be miserable in life. This is called as liberation. So, siddhe svayam swatmane nitya mukte. And when you come to know that you are essentially a man and non-essentially a husband, but we are all miserable because of the non-essentials, not because of the essential. Therefore, kva bandha chinta, kva cha moksha chinta. Where is the problem of bondage and liberation? It is a baby talk. Swamiji, I want liberation. One lady asked me. I said, what will you do after liberation? Suppose you are liberated. What will you do? I will chant Lord's name. Then start now. Imagine you are liberated. Suru roja. Can you tell me how far I am liberated? Mama, I am liberated from you. You go. See, this is not the truth, friends. Bandha moksha. If there is bondage, then there is the possibility of moksha. If there is no bondage, how can you have liberation? See? Na nirodho na cha utpatti na baddho na cha sadhakaha na muktaha na mumukshurvai ittesha paramarthata. Paramartha is that where there is no creation, no destruction, nobody is bound, nobody is liberated, nobody is seeking, nothing is sought. Then just be yourself. Be attentive. when you are just being yourself, world doesn't make any difference. Whether people are following discipline or not, whether they are going in a queue or not, whether ladies and gents are sitting together or not, what type of hairstyle they have. But these people get lost in this non-essential. In one place I went, probably in Bangalore only, many years before, that person told me, probably he was the VHP victim, so he told me that, Swamiji, in this lecture, we are going to the girls' school lecture, kindly make this point. According to our culture and religion, the girls should not cut their hair. This point you brought out, bring out. I said, all right. I went and said, that religion and culture which is destroyed because of the haircut, is it a culture? Baal baal bacha. Don't get lost in this non-essentials, friends. See? When it happens naturally, it is good. When it is done artificially, it is bad. Why? See? So after my lecture, that man told Swamiji, you have just made the wrong way, no? I said, you tell me, why you are worried about the girl's hairstyle? But is it right? I said, no, I'll tell you why you are worried. Why? You don't have hair on your head. Therefore, you are jealous. And they make such beautiful hairstyle and you are worried. Relax. That is not spiritual life. Sat Darshanam. Rupinya rupinya bhayatmikacha mukti stri rupeti vido vadanti idam trayim trayam ya vivinaktidhi handihi tasya pranashaha paramartha mukti. They call sayujya mukti, salokya mukti, sarupya mukti. These are technical terms. There are three types of, four types of, different types of muktis, various brands. Like, you know, the Tata Gold, the Wagh Bakri. Different types of tea, isn't it? Gujaratis have this Wagh Bakri tea. So, once I was taking tea in their house, I said, hey, do you know what is this Wagh Bakri? Wagh means tiger, Bakri means a goat. Why this funny name? How many, we also always feel, why they have kept Wagh Bakri? I said, no. This tells, that when you take this tea, even the enemies may become friends. Wagh and Bakri, they are very good friends if they are over a cup of tea. Therefore, if you want to have good friendship with your wife, take this tea together. Wagh and Bakri. Wife is the Wagh. One man, he was by surname Wagh. You know, in Maharashtra, they got funny surnames. Wagh, Kolle, Kutre, Dukre, all kinds of things. See, so his friend asked, yaar, your name is Wagh. How come you are so much afraid of your wife all the time? He said, you don't know. Her surname at home is Wagh Mare. Therefore, I am very much afraid, you know. I didn't realize it when I got married. She will kill me any day. So these three types of muktis which are told, sarupya mukti, you become same like Bhagavan. Then sayujya mukti. Then sayujya mukti, you go and merge with the Bhagavan. Salokya mukti, you go in the same place where Bhagavan is staying. So if you are Rama's Bhakta, you will go to Saket in New Delhi. If you are Krishna Bhakta, you will go to Golok, where you never come back. See? All these Salokya, Sarupya, Sayujya, all these three muktis become null and void the moment you discover who is inquiring. In me, there is neither bondage, nor mukti, nor liberation. This is Sat Darshanam. nothing to do, nowhere to go. So, idam trayam ya vivinakti handihi tasya pranashaha paramartha mukti. When this I disappears, who is struggling to get something, that itself is liberation. Saddarshanam dravidavangibaddam maharshina sri ramanena shuddham prabandham utkrushtam amartya vanyam anudyavi vasishta munirvyatani. This was originally composed in the Tamil language by Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi, and it was subsequently converted in the Amartyavani, means Sanskrit language. See, this Amartyavani, Sanskrit language, is called a Devavani. Gods speak in Sanskrit. In heavens, they speak Sanskrit. Therefore, one of my Sindhi friends told me, Swamiji, after you told me, I have started learning Sanskrit. When I go to heaven, I won't have difficulty. No, any time I may die. So I am learning Sanskrit. I said, you are real Sindhi. Perfect. Now my question is, you will go to heaven, no doubt about it. Suppose you go to hell then? He said, I know Sindhi. No problem. There is no difficulty. So, this Tamilian composition was redone in Sanskrit by Vasishtha Muni. Sattatva saram saralam dadhana mumuksha lokaya mudam dadhana amanushasri ramaniya vanim vani mayuka bittir muka muni bhir vagvibhati. This is sattatva saram. It is the essence of the sat, the reality, which was written originally in Tamil, but for the seekers of truth to understand easily in the Sanskrit, this is being recasted, and it is something like the original sun is in the sky, and what we see is only the reflected sun. See, friends, so my words are like the reflection, but the original is Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi. In this manner, this Saddarshanan gives us the ultimate glimpses of our own being. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.